This is a Stanford Learning Lab tutorial showing how to take digital notes using Notability in a way that is accessible to all learners. We'll discuss the benefits of digital note-taking and the various features of Notability. While some people are accustomed to physically writing down notes, there are several benefits to digital note-taking. First, digital notes are highly accessible because you can create an organized system of folders, and navigating between notes only takes a few clicks. Second, we often type faster than we write, which allows for more time spent soaking in the lecture itself. Third, digital note-taking can be helpful for those that struggle to read their own handwriting. And fourth, there are a variety of technological applications that allow for digital recordings, text-to-speech translation, and other things that make your notes more accessible. For example, you can upload the lecture slides ahead of time to your digital notes so you can add and annotate rather than write down every word verbatim. Notability can be downloaded and accessed on PCs, Macs, phones, and tablets. There is a free version of Notability if you decide to test it out. Additionally, if you want to try it out with a tablet but don't have one, Stanford gives students the resource to borrow the necessary equipment. Let's now walk through how to use Notability. Notability allows you to create folders based on your subjects, and then all your notes for each subject can be stored neatly in an accessible place. In the left-hand margin, I have psychology, statistics, and biochemistry. Let's open the psychology folder, and we see that there are already two notes here. A popular approach for students is to upload PowerPoint slides and add notes over them, which is what you see here. You can do this by going to File, Import, and selecting a file from your computer or a storage device like Google Drive. You can also deselect slides that you don't want to upload. So I'm going to add a lecture about language to a new note. Let's walk through some of the features with this note. At the top, you'll find several options for adding notes. You can click on the T option if you want to type text into your notes. So with this question, what are some language disorders? I'll type aphasia. The pencil option next to it allows you to write your notes or underline important information, which is especially popular for those that want to use an iPad or tablet with a stylus to physically write their notes as if it were paper. So I could choose to write out aphasia instead. You can use the highlighter icon to highlight important points as you listen to a lesson or review notes afterwards. And you can use the eraser option to erase any drawings or highlights you make while leaving the rest of your notes intact. The lasso icon can be used to copy and paste a section of your notes to move it elsewhere. So let's take this introduction to language and then copy and then paste, and you can see that you can recreate different parts of the slides or different parts of your notes. Additionally, you can transform your written notes into more easily readable text. So let's try that with my messy writing of the word aphasia. So I'm going to take the lasso option, surround aphasia, right click, choose convert text, and it will convert the selection into a text-based font. You can also click the hand scrolling option to move around your notes with a tablet. And you might also try recording yourself out loud if you want to have a brainstorming session and want to replay the audio. You can do this by clicking on the microphone icon. You can also add various types of media such as pictures, videos, and other files from your computer or the internet. While digital note-taking may not be for every student, we hope this tutorial provides information on how to successfully make the switch from hard copy notes to digital notes using Notability. Notability gives you a singular platform to store your notes in convenient and accessible ways. If you want to discuss digital note-taking or developing a reliable note-taking approach with a learning specialist, please contact the Stanford Learning Lab. Thank you for listening.